Our next guest is a Caribbean sensation who's turning on audiences around the globe with his infectious take on island music.
Here to discuss his career and perform his new single, Feel So Good, as multi-platinum recording artist Kevin Lyttle. Welcome to Rise 360.
Hi, Kevin. Thank you so much for being here.
It's an absolute pleasure.
Let's talk about your sound. It's been described as Caribbean soca, but it's a little more than that. It has a little more flavor than that.
Yeah. Well, it actually started out with me having the intention to have the music in St. Vincent take a different direction. Mm-hmm. You know, from where I'm from, we would always do soca music as everything is speed, high speed, you know. And then I just decided, the dancehall music keeps crossing over. Mm-hmm. You got Shabba, you got Shaggy, you got all these great stars from the Caribbean, but the soca music is not doing it. So that was the kind of consciousness I was dealing with at the time when I came up with Turn Me On. I was like, how do I take that sound of soca, which we have in St. Vincent, which is raga soca, mix of dancehall and soca, and mix it with R&B and bring it to the international world? I didn't expect it to work.
It worked in a major way.
What the song was is an interpolation of 112's All My Love.
Oh,
right?
Okay.
So I took an R&B song, totally changed the concept of the song and changed up the melody to suit the type of music that I'm doing, and basically fused everything together. So it's a fusion of R&B, dancehall, and soca.
Well, I like all of your music.
And we've danced to that song.
Oh, yeah. Love it.
Did you have any idea that that song would be such a huge hit?
No,
I mean, it was an international phenomenon.
Right, all the clubs were playing it.
Yeah.
I am onto this day still amazed, because I just sold out the biggest club in Gothenburg like 5 days ago.
Congrats.
In Sweden. 5,000 people, yeah.
Wow.
Just sold that out. Like, I'm like, wow. You know, it's like, it's been 10 years since the record came out in America. 14 years in the Caribbean, and it is just nonstop. It gets played all the time. It's just, you know, it's always relevant. So, you know, I'm very blessed, and I'm very happy for, you know, the life that God has given me and the success that I've been able to achieve.
Well, I think people love your music because it makes us all feel so good,
which
is the title of your new single.
Yeah, man.
Now, it features Shaggy. What was it like working with him?
Well, you know, me and Shaggy has interacted a lot over the years, and he's always such a cool guy. He's a very straight-up person. You know, Shaggy will tell you plain and straight. He'll do it or he'll not do it. You know, he's just straight like that, you know, but he's also a very down-to-earth person, you know, and I had a very good interaction with him. Me and him always get along. Came out to the music video, you know, very humble with me, and we all just got it done, you know what I'm saying? The song itself, it was very easy. I called him, I was like, yo, Shag, I need you on this record. And he listened to the record, he said, yo, I love this record. I'm gonna do it. He did his vocals, sent it back to me, sent it to the producers, and the rest is history.
Mm.
Yeah.
Is that the video?
Yeah.
That looks like a good time. Talk to us about the energy on set. What was that like?
It was crazy. You know, what we're trying to project with this song is a different side of me. In that I'm talking, because, you know, I've gone through a lot of different things throughout the years. Mm-hmm. You know, my mom died in 2008.
Oh, sorry to hear that.
You know, and it kind of threw me into a funk. It kind of held me back. I had a lot of records that I was going to release around the times that she died. And, you know, I kind of got held back a lot, and thanks to the person in my life, now my wife, Dr. Jacqueline James Lyttle, who's present here in studio, I was able to really find my way again, you know, and really see in front of me what was for me and what was not for me, who were for me and who weren't for me, you know, and that's a little bit of the inspiration behind the song. Because when the song was brought to me, it was brought to me with just the chorus, feel so good to be loved, oh, and I wrote all the verses. I came up with the story now for the song.
Now, you mentioned Sweden earlier.
Uh-huh.
You tour all over the world, obviously.
Yes.
Where's your favorite country to perform in?
Wow, there's quite a few. There's no one particular, you know, because I perform in front of so much diverse audiences, and the enthusiasm that I get from people is almost always the same. Mm. You know, back in the day when I first started, I had some instances where I would show up for a show. You get the weird promoter who would not book the right artist, and then call you last minute and put you on a show, and then you get booed because people weren't expected to see you.
Right, right. But what about your hometown, St. Vincent? No. They love you there. And you just recently became the ambassador there, right?
Yes, yes. I'm the cultural ambassador of St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
What does that mean exactly? What do you have to do? Do you have job responsibilities?
Well, and if we want to visit, do we call you up and we get a trip there?
Red carpet? I'll take care of you. Of course.
We're coming to St. Vincent.
I call you and then I call the Prime Minister and I say, Mr. Guns, Dr. Ralph Gonsalves, sir.
Say what?
Dr. Ralph Gonsalves, His Excellency, the Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
Okay.
You know, I set you up good. We got Young Island, which is a very nice resort in St. Vincent, and there's a lot of nice things. You know, what I'm doing now is talking about my country. This is what the job really entails.
Really?
You know, the oldest botanical gardens in the Western Hemisphere is in my country.
Really? St. Vincent?
Yes.
Who knew?
We have the biggest volcano. Down there, it's a sight to see.
Is it active?
No.
Okay.
You can go and hike and enjoy the views. It has a crater about a mile wide. You stand from one end and look at the
other
side.
That's
actually pretty cool. It's crazy, yeah. And the food. The food is excellent.
Yes.
I mean, oh my God, you know, it's Caribbean.
And the parties,
yes, of course. Carnival in St. Vincent and the Grenadines is off the chain. Also, a part of history, we have the oldest known Catholic church in the Western Hemisphere.
Oh,
it's one of the first to be built.
All right. Yeah.
So it's definitely worth a visit.
Yeah, man.
But before that, we want to make sure we hear you sing your new single, Feels So Good. When can we expect the album? This is the single. When can we expect it?
Well, I'm more focusing on singles, but the album is going to be called The Diplomat. I'm not setting a set date on it because, you know, the music industry is going through a lot of changes.
That's
and right
true.
Now, singles are what is really happening a lot, you know, and people put out more EPs. They don't put out so much big album compilations no more. Okay. So, you know, I'm planning the album, but it's a little complicated with when I'm going to release it.
Okay.
You know, we got to get the singles popping first.
Right. We'll go to iTunes.
Right.
We want to hear you in action.
Yeah, well, the single comes out this week.
Okay,
yeah.
So we'll let you go get ready, and we'll make sure everybody at home is getting ready to purchase it when it comes out this week. And now performing his single, Feel So Good, is Kevin Lyttle.
Yeah.
Larger. Yes, Kevin. Kevin, lick a shot.
Turn up the mic, good. Give me some reverb. Get it right.
As long as I got you.